We all crave for communication. We seek for it through family and friends. But most often, our intimate relationships is where we expect to find the most connection. And when we don't, we feel isolated and misunderstood. We let those negative emotions lead to argument, or we just stop communicating at all. To improve communication in your relationship, you must learn how to listen, not how to talk. Many relationships fail because of communication issues. Today, I will share with you 10 communication styles which, in my opinion, will help you communicate effectively in a relationship. Ever heard about micro-positive expressions? Stick with me till the end of this video to find out how it can impact your partner. Howdy, friends! Welcome back to this fear, and hey, we made it to 2021. I wish you a blessed and glorious 2021. We thank God we have seen this year today. Thank you again for tuning in. If you are new, I am Sidrel Esther, image consultant. You are welcome to join this family. Please consider to subscribe and press the bell icon for Let's see how to build and not ruin your relationship with your communication style. Number one, approaching a conversation with your partner. You have to first of all be disarmed. That is, give up the idea that you have to be right. You are not going into a battle that you have to win. This does not mean that you have to compromise, that you can't be angry or frustrated. No, 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 no. That is not what I'm talking about. You have a right to all of your thoughts and feelings. Just bear in mind that your partner may have something to say that is worth listening to and considering. Having a conversation with your partner is not going to a battlefield where you must prove that you are right. Secondly, identify your communication styles. Not everyone has the same way to communicate. Some people like to talk, some like to touch, and some are more visual. You probably know your communication style, but do you know your partner's communication style? How does your partner respond to communication? Does he or she respond to seeing and watching, touching and doing, or hearing and talking? If, for example, your partner is more responsive to language or tone, making facial expressions may not be communicating to them as you think. You are sending signals, but they are not picking them up because it is not their style of communication. Thirdly, ensure that the timing is correct. It is wise to find the correct time to tell your partner what you have in mind. If the timing is not correct, hold on until you find the appropriate time to tell him what you have in mind. Something that may be rejected if you express it now may be actually heard by your partner if you express it at the right time. We most often than not bring things up when we are annoyed or frustrated. Learn to pick your timing. Fourthly, break negative patterns. The way you speak to each other can affect your relationship. Experts on communications break down the way we talk into pitch, timbre, volume, and pace. The next time you are in a disagreement with your partner, make sure to modulate these aspects of your voice. A voice that is overly high pitch sounds defensive. Also, if you end a sentence with a higher pitch, it sounds like a question. Please avoid this except you are really asking a question, for you may instill doubt in your partner. Timbre refers to your voice's emotional qualities, attitude, or tone. Pay close attention to this and watch out for timbre's red flag like sarcasm, which can erode communication in your relationship and cause distrust. Be careful with the volume of your voice and avoid competing. Competition will only lead to shouting and miscommunication. Being louder won't help you communicate with your partner. Pace means how fast you are talking. When you are disagreeing, slow down. Speak clearly and calmly to get your message across. When things get out of hand, break the pattern by injecting humor in the situation. This will help to remind you that you can enjoy time together even when things seem challenging. There are two people in every relationship, so please don't shift the blame entirely on your partner's shoulders. Breaking the pattern can help reframe the discussion and bring it back to the level where you can get to what matters. It's all about feeling fulfilled in your relationship. Number 5, prioritize your intimacy. Intimacy plays a vital role in communication. During intimacy, hormones that are responsible for bonding are released. The more intimate you are with your partner, the better for your communication. Discuss your sex life. It shows a real connection. How many times a week is satisfactory for both parties? I said both parties, not one man, not how many times a man should be satisfied. Both parties, man, woman, two people, not one person. It's not all about one person. It's not behind. Don't leave me like this, na man. No. It has to be for both of you. What do you need from your partner for a fulfilling sexual relationship? Discussing your sexual fantasy will enable you to build solid trust, communicate better, and bring excitement into your relationship. It should not be a one-sided issue where it is only a man's need that have to be satisfied. No. It is about both parties. You and me. Me and you. Two. Not one person. It's not all about you men. For once in your life, for those who are not doing it, please remember that in a relationship, there are two people. You are not single. If you are single, it will not be a relationship. So it is not about you satisfying your needs. You have to remember that there is another person also. Think of that person. Let it be a two-sided, not one-sided relationship for a better communication and a healthy relationship. Please also learn to say what feels good or not. Giving verbal cues is a great way of communication. It's not that you are counting the ceilings or... Ladies, please, it's not time that you will be there and be thinking when is the doctor's appointment for the children tomorrow, or how you will have to take the child to school, or what you are going to eat in the evening. You have to concentrate, please. It is time for concentration, two of you, and be giving verbal cues for better communication. It's not only one man, he will shout his own shout and come and shout your own shout also, because you are there concentrating. What do we eat tomorrow? Or how the children are going to dress to go to school? For once, also think of yourself. We know we have much to do, girls. I feel you. We have a lot to do, but for one time, keep the children aside. Keep the family aside and concentrate too. Because by the time you will be concentrating to go to that 11th heaven, he will leave you in hellfire. So if you know what is good for you, you better concentrate so that both of you will climb the heaven. It doesn't have to go to heaven, you stay in hellfire. The children breakfast or whatever will take care of itself afterwards. One thing at a time. Communication has to be in all aspects of your relationship. Number 6, communications should be mutual. As you communicate with your partner, take note of the number of times you say I, you, or we. If all is about yourself, then it is not a communication. And if you are also saying you all the time, then what is the context? Are you pointing fingers and placing blame? Relationships should be mutual and each person should have an equal say about things. You both need to feel heard and be able to share what's on your mind. Number 7, respond to criticisms with empathy. When your partner comes with criticisms, it is easy to feel that they are wrong and get defensive. While criticisms is hard to hear and often colored by the other person's emotions, it is very important to listen to their pain and respond with empathy for their feelings. Look for what is true in what your partner is saying. That can be valuable information for you. Number 8, take a break. At times, tempers get heated and it is just too difficult to continue a communication without it becoming an argument. If you feel yourself or your partner starting to become too angry to be constructive, you can take a break from the discussion until you both cool off. You can take a walk, sleep on it, or whatever seems fit for both of you. Good communication also means knowing when to take a break. Number 9. Communicate. Don't sweep things under the carpet. It can be very tempting to avoid difficult conversation just to keep the peace. This is very risky because you keep putting off talking about things until you finally get depressed because the tension has been building over time. It is better to get little things out rather than accumulating issues that risk causing damage to your relationship. If there are issues that keep bothering you over and over, it is better to discuss them than keep them bothering you. And finally, this brings us to our number 10, the micro-positive expressions. Dr. Paul Ekman, an influential psychologist, defines micro-expression as the involuntary facial expression that occurs within 1/25th of a second, which can accurately reflect a person's true emotion. These expressions can be negative or positive, and research has shown the compelling impact they can have on other people. Whether it is a scowl or rolling of your eyes, these are micro-negative behaviors that may cause your partner to feel unsafe to connect with you. On the other hand, micro-positive behaviors like smiles, nodding, or leaning in will cause your partner to feel more relaxed to connect with you. Nod during a conversation, respond with smile when appropriate, and lean in to show your partner that you are engaged and listening to what he or she is saying. Friends, I pray this relationship's advice will give you the clarity you need to improve communication in your relationship. If you love this video, please share and subscribe to help me promote this channel. Thank you again for watching. Remember to be the real you. We are in 2021, and let your image do the talking. See you in the next video. Happy New Year! A bientôt!